Hi, I'm Jack from Shure.
Andy from Yamaha.
And we are going to integrate our SLX-D Q with the DM7 that we have here behind us. So Andy, first question, SLX-D Q, what consoles can I currently integrate with that device?
Yeah, well, right now it is the DM7 series, as that's the latest series of devices that have had a firmware update since the launch of the marvelous SLX-D units. So other consoles will follow, like the Rivage PM series.
Okay, so eventually all of the consoles in your portfolio will talk to the SLX-D units and follow a similar kind of workflow to get them in the system.
Indeed.
Excellent. And on the other side, what can DM7 currently talk to in our portfolio?
Yeah, well, all the devices you have there, so all of the SLX-D range, all of the ULX-D range, the QLX-D range, and the Axient, both the digital and the previous generation of the analog AXT 400 units.
Excellent stuff. Mm. So complete integration both sides.
Yeah.
Let's have a look at what we need to do on the Shure side to get this up and running. Now, if you saw the Axient digital video, this is going to be slightly different because the unit is slightly different. We don't have a 4-port Ethernet switch on the back of the SLX-D unit. We have a 2-port Ethernet switch on the back of the SLX-D unit. And that can be configured in a couple of different ways. Helpfully for us today, the factory reset mode is switched, which means primary Dante and Shure control come out of both of those ports, meaning we can speed up our network topology, one cable straight to the desk, and we're up and running.
Fantastic.
Two other ways we can run that though. We can do a redundant mode.
Yep.
And the redundant mode has Shure primary control and Dante primary on the left-hand side and redundant Dante only on the right-hand side. So if you're setting up a redundant Dante network, that's the one that you're going to need.
So it sounds like that works in exactly the same way as the Yamaha devices are configured.
Absolutely correct. The third way that this unit can run is what we call split. And in that mode, we are completely separating Shure control and primary Dante. So Shure control will be on the left-hand side and primary Dante will be on the right-hand side. The reason why we have that mode is certain installations in kind of corporate environments and things of that nature, they require those protocols to go in completely different directions and not cross over. But for this example, we're going to leave it in the factory default mode, which is switched. The only thing that I want to do on the unit itself is put that Yamaha name in the Dante system.
Yep, if you don't do that, we're not going to control it.
Absolutely. So as a quick recap then, we'll go into the unit here. We scroll down to device configuration. We scroll down to Dante. And I've got Dante device name here. And as we can see at the moment, there is no Dante device name set, so it will just be the name of the device that appears in Dante controller. And same as Axion, I can set a sequential number, which just numbers them based on the rack. Could be quite useful if you just want to get stuff into Dante quickly. But for this, we're going to set the Yamaha name. So it's going to give it that Y00 name. And if I scroll down, I can see it goes to Y001 as the default. In this example, this is the first device in my rack. So that's what I'm going to stick with. I'm going to hit apply. System warns me that the Dante name change will disrupt the audio, so same rules apply as last time. Don't do this in the middle of the show. Do this at a time that makes sense. And I press to continue, and we should be up and ready to go. Just a couple of last things that I want to do to make sure that my network is running correctly. I've got wireless workbench here, which is looking after the control side of things. So if I identify all the devices in this rack, they should flash, showing me that I have a healthy network up and running. And same as before, I can use Dante controller to very quickly find my SLX-D unit and just make sure those device settings are where I want them to be. And if I look at the device config, I can see in this example, the sample rate is set at 48K and I cannot change it. That is because the SLX-D unit is a fixed 48K device and that has quite a big impact on your side of things.
Yes, all the devices do need to work at the same sample rate to successfully have audio connection. But the DM7 series and the Rivage PM series all work at 96 kHz by default. Now, they can be put down to 48 kHz to be compatible with the SLX-D series, but you don't need to necessarily do that. You may want to stay at 96 kHz because of your other devices in the system, perhaps to make use of the lower latency that it brings. useful for in-ear monitoring, for example. So there are three ways, let's say, to solve the issue of different sample rates. There's a beginner mode, let's say, basic, intermediate, and advanced mode. We'll get to them in a minute, but Chris, to get control between the devices is going to be the same no matter what we do with the audio. And even we can have control without having successful audio connections. So we'll do the control first, and then we'll talk through the solutions for the sample rate thing. But yeah, the most basic way would be to turn everything to 48 kilohertz and have it all compatible. So shall we look at the control side of things?
Absolutely. First,
and then we'll work on the sample rate solutions.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah. So we are going to start in the menu here. And if we go to start in the setup menu here, let's just go to the word clock here. And we can see by default, we have Dante at 96 kilohertz here. So we could just switch to 48 kilohertz and connect everything, but we like a challenge, or we want to do what our, to show what our customers may want to do. So we'll show a solution with that. Next, we go to the IO device menu. And here in the Dante setup, we can go to the setup, and here we have the same settings that we would find in the Rivage series of consoles and in the CL and QL series. So first, we need a Dante control ID. If you only have one mixer in your system, choose ID number one, because that will determine the sample rate, bit depth, and latency used for the other Yamaha I/O devices in the system. If you have more consoles, you have to choose another ID number. If you've got more than four consoles, it's a bit tough because only four can do device control. The other consoles, you have to switch the ID off. If the ID is off, you can't control anything. So that's a limitation to be aware of. Next, secondary port, similar to the options on the Shure devices, daisy chain, that's what you guys call switched mode. We call it daisy chain mode, where you can link devices together in a chain. Then Dante patch by, we'll keep this console option. So we can do patching in the Dante network from the mixing desk. Then bit depth and latency have no impact on the actual control side of things. So choose what suits your network. Preferred leader and sync to external determine how the Dante network relates to the word clock in the DM7. Now, do you remember in the setup and the word clock page, we had the console getting its clock from Dante. The Dante module is providing clock for the whole DM7 console. Therefore, we don't want to switch on sync to external because this is clock from a Dante point of view. The clock is in Dante, it's not external, so we don't sync to external. Making it the preferred leader means the DM7 is going to be the leader Dante device in the network. So that is all done. Next, let's get some control of the devices. We can move over to device mount. And here we can control up to 24 devices. And I've already got control of one, our IO unit in the rack behind you. We want to get control of the Shure device. I've just closed the menu, forgive me. We go there, back into the menu, and we're in the IO device, Dante setup, device mount. Touch any of the blank spaces, and then we see a list of all the devices we could control. But we want to see what's online, so we go there. And now we see all the devices that we have connected. And here at the top, Y001, Shure SLX-D. Let's press device identify, and we can flash the front panel. So let's connect by touching OK. And we see that's connected, touch there. And then we see the detail. Look, it's connecting, it's synchronizing, and it's going to become controllable. Now we get a little overview of all the parameters. Touch there and we see the parameters in more detail. We can see and edit the channel name. We can see the frequency there. We can see and edit the RX gain, battery status and RF status there. And then port assign status, which we don't need if we are connecting via Dante at the same sample rate, but we will need if we are connecting with a different sample rate, which we are doing now, aren't we? So we have control, but we don't see any audio because of that sample rate mismatch, effectively. So what are we going to do? Well, we talked about a basic mode, which is putting everything in 48 kilohertz. Then a intermediate mode would be just to use an analog connection. So use an analog cable from the back of the SLX-D into the back of the DM7 or into another IO unit and connect that way. So in that case, we would choose from here the analog port that we're connecting for the audio. So if I was to choose here for input one, if I was to choose input one on the back of the mixing desk like that, then that gain control would follow the patch of input one to channel one. And over there, look, channel one has the control available up there. Let's touch and see more detail. So the control follows the patch here. So that is the intermediate method. What about the advanced way? That involves an extra Dante card and a sample rate converter, okay? So we have in the back of this console a PY card slot, and we have put a Dante card in that, a PY64D, that's a 64 channel in and out Dante card, which has sample rate converter built in. That card could run at 48 kilohertz while the console and the built-in Dante port runs at 96 kilohertz, and we can connect them to the same Dante network. Let me show you what that looks like. Back to the setup menu, and then down to PY slot. A little picture of the PY card there. Shares the control ID, but you can change the port mode and the bit depth and latency. And we are going to switch on SRC, sample rate converter, there. And if we were to look in Dante Controller, we would see and we could change the sample rates. Or I can go to word clock here and I can see that the PY card is running at 48 kilohertz there while the console is running at 96. So now what we need to do is do a Dante patch for the audio from the SLX-D to the PY card. Now we're going to need to do that in Dante Controller software, because the patching in the console is only able to patch the audio that comes into the built-in Dante port.
Excellent.
So
I can do that for you. That's
could you? Work. Yeah. So find the SLX-D and patch it to the first four channels of the PY64D.
Of the PY64D, there it is. Mm. They are going to get patched now. There we go.
Fabulous. So now we can go back to where we see the control on the console. So IO device, SLX-D, and down in the port assign now, you can see I've already got PY234 there. So here I need to choose PY slot. Channel one. Ooh, we can see audio.
Oh, how exciting.
Already. Yes, we got progress. So that audio is coming in. That's the Dante patch. Now we need to do the console patch to get the PY inputs to the channels. So we go to the patch menu and input channel patch. And then we can scroll along to pass the built-in Dante channels, 144 of them. So yeah, takes a moment to slide through them. Then we get a few USB inputs, then we get the PY inputs. So let's do PY1 to channel one there, and then let's do those four. So we've made the channel patch. Let's have a look on the screen over here at the channel overview. We have four channels worth of control. Go to a single channel, channel one, we've got the control there. And we can touch up there to see an overview of one channel or look at 12 channels in a row, just like that.
Let's have a little look at what we've got here. So this handheld is synced to channel one of the SLX-D. And if I speak into it, one, two, we can see audio metering here. We have the same receiver gain control that we saw in the Action Digital System. So that's adjusting the gain at the receiver itself, which is the top of the gain tree. That's a really nice place to be making gain adjustments for your system. Mm. We can also see the RF level. So that's the RSSI, the Receive Signal Strength Indicator, how much RF energy is hitting the antennas at this particular frequency. And we can see the battery level as well. So again, if I'm a Lone Ranger, I'm having to do monitoring, front of house, RF tech, patch, whatever it is in my venue or my church or wherever it happens to be, I have a nice overview of everything that's happening on this microphone in one place rather than having to go between a rack and a console to get there.
Yeah, that's right. One thing to bear in mind though, and again, similar to on the Rivage PM series, is the RX gain from the wireless mic systems is not stored in the scene memories of the console. Use the digital gain down here if you need to adjust levels scene by scene.
Awesome. So quick recap then. We arrived, we got some SLX-D, we got a DM7. We factory reset the SLX-D to its switched mode. So primary Dante and Shure control come out of both ports, connected that up to the DM7. We put the Yamaha device name into the SLX-D system, confirmed that the network was healthy, flashed it in Workbench, checked it in Dante Controller, and then confirmed that SLX-D was running at 48K. As you said, a couple of ways that you can get around that. We can either pad the whole thing down to 48, but I guess another really good example is if you're integrating lots of Dante devices together and many of them run at 96, then you would need to do your method of a second Dante card and then have a sample rate conversion up.
Right, yeah. That allows you to run concurrently 96 kilohertz devices and 48 kilohertz devices.
I think making these videos, one thing that's really landed for me is the need to remember that there's a Dante patch in and then a patching of the Dante to the console side. So yeah. In both instances, we had to get the SLX-D patched into Dante in a way that made sense. But that is actually only half of the story. We then need to map those Dante inputs to the console itself.
Yeah, that's right. A network patch and a console patch.
Amazing. Well, thanks, Andy. Really appreciate you coming in and walking us through that. Hope these videos have been useful for you. I think it's fair to say if you want any more information from either side of this, both of our websites are fairly well stocked with information on how to get these systems set up. And yeah, by the time these videos come to you, we should see SLX-D quads available on the wider Yamaha range, which is really, really exciting.
Yeah.
Wicked. Thanks, Andy. Hope this was useful. We'll see you on the next videos.